Hello everyone. Myself Nabanita Daimari, Assistant Professor, Civil Engineering Program, Assam Downtown University. Today, I'll be discussing with you the pre-stressed concrete bend tendons with parabolic profile. We have discussed the bend tendons with a triangular shape or a triangular profile, but today we'll be discussing about the bend tendons which are parabolic in profile. So, and also will solve a problem so that you can understand it better. So let's get started with it. So this is a tendon with parabolic profile. You can see the figure here. This is a pre-stressed beam which is carrying a externally uniformly distributed load here, which is W. W per unit run. The tendon is provided here with a parabolic profile. When the cable is provided with a parabolic profile, it will exert a uniformly upward pressure, like you can see in this figure here. Okay. This parabolic profile, when it is provided with a parabolic profile, the tendons are provided with a parabolic profile. What it will do, it will exert an uniformly distributed upward pressure WC in this way. This way, this way, this way, and so on. It is going to distribute an upward pressures throughout its profile. Okay, so and there will be therefore received a downward uniformly. So this profile, this bent tendon with a parabolic profile, this is going to give an external, it is going to give an upward pressure of WC uniformly throughout the bent tendon. So also, it is going to similarly, since this is uniformly distributed, the external load, this is also going to be equally distributed downwards to all the loads. So in this way, the bent tendons are going to give an upward thrust for the uniformly distributed load here on the bent tendon. Okay, like here you can see in this figure, this was the WC per unit run loads transmitted to the beam due to the bent tendon. Then, and also WC per unit run loads transmitted to the tendon. In the tendon also, due to the external load, these loads are also transmitted uniformly to the bent tendon. So we have studied in the theory of cables also that a cable which is carrying a uniformly distributed load on the whole span, it has a horizontal reaction at each end of the cable, here at each end of the cable, which is given by WC L squared by 8H. Now from this we can get WC value, so that we can know what is the upward thrust actually. So PX also we can consider it to be P, approximately it is equal to the P, and H is what? H is nothing but the dip, this dip of the cable. That means this is your dip. Okay, so now if you see here, if we consider these things, we can easily find out our WC value, which is 8PH by L square. Now this you have to remember, that is WC, the total uniformly distributed load which is acting upward from the parabolic profile due to the parabolic profile of the pre-stressed force. So that is given by 8PH by L square. Now hence a parabolic tendon carrying a tension P will provide an upward uniformly distributed load of this much, as I told you, per unit length of the beam. Hence, the upward uniform pressure supplied by the parabolic tendon will counteract the part of the external downward uniformly applied load. The net downward load on the beam is therefore equal to W minus WC. Okay, like this is your upward thrust WC. So also what will be your, this is your downward force, so this will be counterbalanced by WC, and then the remaining load is going to create the stresses here on the beam. So let us solve a problem. If we take a problem here, but The problem says what? The figure shows a prestressed concrete beam provided with a bent tendon having a parabolic profile. If the total external load on the beam is 35 kN on the whole span, calculate the extreme stresses of the here mid span section. You have to calculate the entire stresses at the top and at the bottom. The tendon carries a prestressing force of 1000 kN. So now we have to, at the mid span, we have to, question demands us to find out the the stresses for the mid span section. That means at the top fiber, you have to find out at the mid span the top stress, and at the bottom, what is the stress. So now we already know what are the stresses here. Since this is a parabolic profile, there will be an upward thrust. See, this is the solution to the question. That is the area we know. This much, the dimensions are given, so 400 into 600, we got it to be area this much. Section modulus, you know how much it is, BD squared by 6. Span is given to be 6 meter. This is a dip. Dip is given to be 100 mm, so that is 0.10 meter. So now, what will be the upward thrust? As we have discussed now, upward thrust WC is how much? Given by 8PH by L square. So let us put the value 8PH by L square, where 8 is 8. Now P is what? P is the pre-stressing force, which is given to be 1000 kN. H is the dip, which is 0.10 meter. Then we have the span is 6 meter. So that it gives us to be the upward thrust per unit per meter, it gives to be 22.22 kilonewton per meter. So we have a UDL of already 35 kilonewton per meter. So this is going to be counterbalanced by this 22.22 kilonewton per meter wise. So that is how much the net load will be now. Downward load will be how much? This 35 minus your 22.2. This 35 kilonewton will be counterbalanced, tried to counterbalance by 22.2 kilonewton per meter, and therefore some amount of loads will be remaining, that is now to be 12.78 kilonewton per meter. Now this is our bending load per meter, UDL. So now what will be the moment due to this? WL square by 8. If we see W is this, square is L is how much? 6 meter square. So now the moment is 57.51 kilonewton meter. So we can easily calculate our stresses. Okay, we can easily calculate our stresses, which is P by A plus minus M by Z. P we know 1000 kilonewton, area we already calculated, moment is 57.51 kilonewton meter, and Z we have calculated to be 2.4 into 10 to the power 7. So in this way we will get the total 4.17 plus minus 2.40 newton per mm square, which is your how much? This was our bent tendon. So the extremes, next class we will be discussing this load balancing method. Now here extreme stress at the top is how much? 4. This was your P by A, 4.17, which is uniform. Then we have the stress due to bending moment is M by Z, which is 2.4 newton per mm square plus minus. So compression at the top and bottom we have tension, so the stress, the total stress here at the top will be how much? 4.17 plus 2.40, which gives us to be 6.57, and the next at the bottom is 4.17 minus, we have this minus 2.4 newton per mm square, which gives to be 1.77 newton per mm square. So that means the entire our beam, which is with a parabolic profile here in this question, is under compression, and at the top with a value of stress 6.57 newton per mm square, and at the bottom we have 1.77 newton per mm square. So this was how you can calculate how your parabolic profile gives an upward thrust per meter, okay, and then how we can calculate these stresses. So this was with your parabolic profile, how you solve it. So yeah, thank you so much. See you in the next class.